question is, Vice, everybody else, you have comments?
Yes, you know, I really appreciate the comments from the public this morning, in all the different forms and with all their different opinions. I think they're all important. Mr. Hoffman's comment, I think, resonates with me that I'd rather be discussing the best way to fund our transportation needs rather than the only options that we have available to us. Unfortunately, that is not the conversation that we're having this morning, due to a lot of different reasons. We could point fingers at everybody, but I'm not going to do that this morning. I don't think there's time for that. I think the reality is that this is a proposal that's fair to the constituents in District 5 that I represent, that up until this point have been left off the table when we spend property tax dollars on road improvements. Last year, this board approved $10 million to be spent out of property taxes on local roads. District 5 got zero. Zero. And we pay property taxes just like everybody else, in the same amounts, per assessed value. Not a fair proposition. But we understand that it's important to share those dollars and to make sure that the roads that we all drive on, because believe it or not, when I bring my passport with me, I can go past River Road and drive on Thornydale and Ina and not be fearful of getting stopped by the Border Patrol, but rather I have a little better roads to be able to drive on. That's important to me. That's important to the folks in District 5 too. We are not naive to that. We see the better picture, the bigger picture. But that doesn't mean we don't want fairness. This provides some level of equity. The other thing I'd say is that I'd like very much for the funds that are designated for District 5 to work closely together with the City of Tucson Bond Advisory Committee. Is that what you guys call it? More or less, you know what I'm talking about, Jesse, Ramon. You were here today. Thank you very much. I think that's good. I think we need to have staff look at a process that works for all five of the districts and how we're going to go about spending that dollars for transparency's sake. Because as it stands right now, having the supervisors make those decisions by themselves is a little quirky. And it shouldn't be that way. We should walk away. So those are my initial comments. As usual, public safety takes the lion's share of this year's budget. Probably 60% of our general fund dollars are spent on public safety between the sheriffs, the county attorneys, the courts, three jails that we operate. It is problematic, but those are important functions that I don't think we really want to tear apart. What we want to do is continue working at them so that they become more and more efficient. And frankly, I think that the work that the MacArthur Grant has brought us in terms of looking at people who are incarcerated in Pima County Jail is probably a smart move. Reducing the number of people that are in prison, or in jail, excuse me, not in prison, is helpful to us. They keep their jobs. Hopefully, they keep helping their kids be able to eat and their families be able to pay the bills. Because if they're doing time in PCJ, not only when they get out and they live in District 5 and you become a bingo, that's what we call them, their families have a chance at finding some success. And hopefully, they can get their act together as they face their court dates in whatever kind of punishment the judges mean out to them. Those are important issues for us all. So I'll stop there for right now.
Okay, thank you. And I echo, actually, agree with everything you've said.
And I intend to work with Supervisor Christie and others to go to the state legislature, as Mr. Huffman talked about.
Objection.
Well, Supervisor Valdez and Supervisor Lewis.
Madam Chair and staff, what was the appropriate person? At this point, what was the final state budget diversion from PERF for DPS?
It was in the memo here somewhere. Anybody know offhand? Where?
Ms. Carrick, Mr. Johnson.
Madam Chairman, the board, it's about $80 million. We can get the exact number.
What, I'm sorry, 80?
80 million, yes.
So $80 million out of the fund. Madam Chair, Ms. Lesher, is that going to roads?
I believe it's going to the Department of Public Safety for officers.
Okay, so I guess that must not be an issue, that her funds are not going to roads.
No, it's going to puppies.
The truth is that we are in a situation where we have tried, we have gone to the federal government, we have met with our delegation, we've gone to the state government, we've asked them to talk about it, and to their credit, at least this year, they talked about it, which is not something they've done in the past. Because frankly, this is not an issue that is a Pima County only issue. It's everywhere in Pima County, it's everywhere in Arizona, it's everywhere and across the country.
No, sir.
The truth is, Madam Chair, if I could have the full
yes,
budget.
Yes, you can have the full.
And it's a problem everywhere. The truth is, we built this infrastructure in a previous generation to a great degree, and we haven't maintained it. We haven't maintained it here or anywhere else across this country. And we continue to look upon it and say, that's an issue. Yep, that's an issue. That's an issue. That's an issue too over here. That doesn't solve the problem. That's not a solution. So what are we going to do to solve this problem? Magically, is any other level of government going to come up with a solution? I don't think so. And regardless of who's in charge, the issue has not been addressed. We have failed in that regard. At every level of government. What we have in this proposal, whether or not you like it or not, is an opportunity. It is an opportunity to finally step up to the plate and say, I'm in the batter's box and I'm going to take a cut at this the next pitch. Because frankly, no one else has. And no one else has stepped up to the plate and said, I'm going to do it. And again, the roads aren't getting better. On this dais, over and over and over and over, and I cannot emphasize how many times I hear that roads are a problem, that arterials are a problem, that neighborhood roads are a problem. And I agree. And we haven't had the resources to do anything about it. Well, you know what? This is an opportunity to do something about it. The question is not whether or not we have an opportunity, because it is here. The question is whether or not we have the courage. And it is a question that we need to ask ourselves, because that need is going to continue to grow. So the question we need to ask ourselves today is whether or not we have the courage to just talk about it, or the courage to actually do something about it. It's very simple. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Supervisor Lee.
And wow, that's a bunch of shit.
Please don't interrupt the speaker. Please abide by the rules of civility.
Yes, please do.
I certainly appreciate Supervisor Valdez's comments. I think he's exactly right on this one. And we've heard it. And we've heard it loud and long for a long time, but the answers remain elusive. And I'm fifth generation Tucsonan. I've watched politics pretty much all my life. I grew up in a household where we were pretty obsessed with the issue and dealt with it from the time we were little kids, frankly. I haven't seen the state legislature fix anything for Pima County in a good way throughout my entire life, and I admit I'm only 58 years old, so that's bad record. If that's what we're going to depend on to help out Pima County and fix things so that we can get our roads taken care of, I'm sorry, I think you're living in Candyland. You know, that game is fun, but there's winners and losers in that one. And I guarantee you, if the state legislature gets involved, we're going to be on the losing end of that no matter what. Time to get those up there. And I think the second point that
Supervisor Valdez made is, frankly, they're diverting HERF funds to pay for DPS officers. I don't blame them. We need them out there. But certainly that's not road repair. Not at all. So that's hypocrisy as well. And there's a certain amount of hypocrisy being floated around here about our commission surrounding a sales tax increase. Getting a 5-0 vote here amongst this board of supervisors is rare, other than ministerial acts that we all have to complete. And folks who have been complaining the most about road conditions this morning are the folks who object to this particular methodology and attempt to try and put together the dollars necessary for our regions. It's kind of a false argument. It's an empty soup. Let's be real. Let's be honest. The cavalry isn't coming. We need to fix this problem ourselves, and we need to get going on it. And we need to make sure that we have the clarity and the transparency that we need. We've already talked about working together with the other jurisdictions, because that portion of this whole proposal is lacking. We want to be good. I certainly want to be good to the jurisdiction that the majority of my residents live in. So let's step up to the plate. Let's take on the challenges that face us. Let's be strong. Let's move on. I think we've had a good discussion here this morning, and I'm very proud of all the members, and I think everybody's made some good points, but I think it's time to move on and start looking at adopting these various budgets that we have in front of us.
Thank you, and I've got some final comments before we move to adoption. And